Hi everyone. Welcome to Goodbye Bullshit, Hello Happiness, Magical Curiosities Edition with Sarah here. Hello, Sarah. And what else are we going to talk about other than magic? So today's topic is what is magic? And in particular, what is your magic? And really, it is, let's call there is this unreal, not real, unseen realm that we're all connected to, and people experience it in different ways. A lot of people may be getting number sequences all the time, a particular sequence, or when they're really doing something and they want a message and they get that number sequence. So that could be a way that they're connected to that magical, unseen, not real, not part of the reality realm. Other people may be signs that they see. It could be signs on a truck. It could be license plates. It could be a song you get. It could be somebody sends you a text right there that has a meaning, special meaning for you. So those messages are another kind of a way that you connect to magic. Then there is my favorite, nature. Nature is the best magic. You go for walks, you're sitting next to a window. It can be squirrels coming talking to you. And yes, no, they're not actually speaking English to you, but you know there's a communication, there's a connection there that you're gonna feel, you're gonna sense things. Birds, trees, everything and anything in nature can bring you messages and you can connect with it. If you're receiving feathers, a lot of people walk around. I know for me, I have like so many feathers here, but you find feathers. There could be hearts. You know, I get hearts. I have a client, she gets four-leaf clovers all the time. That's another way that you're connecting. And then expand on that. There is communication with spirits, whether they're your higher spirits, animal spirits, or it could also be spirits of loved ones that have passed away. You know, if you're a medium, that's kind of your gift. So there's all sorts of ways that we are in touch and in communication with this unseen, not part of reality realm that I call it's your magic. It's your way of receiving, communicating with something that's so different that takes you away. And what's needed there when you get into that space is basically trust. Trust in yourself, trust in your knowing. And not dismissing what's coming to you, sort of taking it on. And other people may say, oh, you know, it's coincidence, whatever. I always come back to again, if it feels good to you, go with it. If it feels good in your heart, go with it. Don't worry about what others are going to say or think. Don't dismiss it. Trust in yourself, trust in the universe, trust in the messages. And trust your heart. That's the other part of this, other than trust, is that connection that you're gonna get with your heart that's stronger. Your intuition is gonna guide you there, and you're gonna feel your heart more when you're in that space of magic. So I just wanted to get us started, and I'm gonna pass it on to Sarah to get her view on this. Go
So,
ahead.
I love everything you just said. And I have to be honest, there's a part of me that was listening and thinking, man, I wish I had gotten this message when I was five. Because, you know, especially you talk about the trusting in your own sort of feeling, right? That like it's something that excites your heart or invigorates you or makes you feel good. And everyone else around you is like, why are you reacting this way? Like, I don't understand. Actually, a specific example for some reason that's been niggling in my ear was, I remember the first time, like the first several times in my life, I saw ocean and saw the sun reflecting off the waves, like the ripples mm-hmm. in the ocean. And I just remember trying to tell my parents, oh my God, it looks like jewels. It's sparkling jewels. And I was just like so excited. And they were just sort of like, okay, yeah, it's reflection on water. Mm-hmm. That was like, no, it's so much bigger than that. And the thing is now, right, I am able to find that space, that five-year-old space, right, where, and that's really what it is. It's like, we're talking about almost like remembering, at least for me. I feel like my magic, I felt for sure when I was a child and just started repressing it because nobody seemed to agree with me or understand what I was talking about. So you just stop trusting yourself mm-hmm. and you stop trusting your perspective, your intuition, your knowing. And it's like my personal journey has been coming back to that, like finding a way of living in the world, being willing to express my own self without worrying about how other people see that, whether they'll say, oh, she's crazy, or oh, she talks to spirits, like what a weirdo, you know, whatever. Yeah. And that's so profound. Like, even in this moment, I'm feeling the weight of saying that. It cannot be overstated how profound allowing yourself to have those experiences, to feel them authentically and deeply. It is life-changing.
It is. It's magic. It really is.
Completely. Yes.
Because it is that, it's like your heart singing again. It's like your heart opening up, your heart getting to experience without that fear, without that sort of that protection, that wall around it. It's able to feel and experience and express itself. And it's such a beautiful thing. And it is trust, and sometimes it's just you enjoying, like you, a five-year-old you that enjoyed seeing jewels on the ocean, to her it was jewels. And everybody else was like, yeah, that's reflection. Or, you know, I always make fun of my own stuff, is that I, you know, you've seen the photos I take, you know, those light, it looks like bubbles and forms in there and colors. Faces and everything.
And butterflies.
Exactly. I love those. I love, and everybody's like, well, that's just like your reflection of the light. Exactly.
Yes, it's lens flare. And I'm like, whatever.
Yes, even if it is lens flare, how beautiful and magical yes. that a lens flare can look so awesome.
Yes.
I can't see it with my eyes. I can see it like that. How awesome is that? So don't let people's, everybody likes to, you know, be what, that's why I distinguish between real and unreal, or seen and unseen, is because so many people are already so attached to this so-called real world and the reality of things. And if you are really wanting that, to connect and communicate with your authentic self and to have that enlightenment, awareness, spiritual awakening, whatever it is that you're talking about, you have got to be willing to experience magic like this, be able to put away those noises and not let it sort of dampen your mood and your light when you get excited about seeing jewels in the water, or, you know, for me, those lens flares that look like awesome colors and bubbles and shapes and forms. Get excited. Don't let others dampen that. And I like what you said about kids. And you work with kids as well, so you know this best. If you have kids, please encourage them. When they come and see things, and when they come and experience things, Just a little story, and I'm sorry I'm taking too much of Sarah's time here.
No.
But I had a client, she was interesting. She had mainly come because of her daughter's experiences. They have a predominantly Christian home, and it took her a couple of sessions to actually get out why she was here, which was her daughter was experiencing astral travel. She would just, she said, you know, she, at night she's saying she is going to these places she doesn't know, she's meeting people she doesn't know, she's, but it's only at night, and she knows she's not dreaming, and she didn't have any words around it. So when I gave her some ways to communicate with her daughter and for her to let her daughter know, first of all, her daughter's okay, there's nothing wrong with her daughter, that she's safe, everybody's safe, and there are ways that she can even do that without getting afraid. And it was life-changing for their household, because it was like the daughter was happier, she wasn't stressed, she wasn't anxious anymore, she didn't think there was something wrong with her. And the mom and dad were now engaged with her and saying, no, this is okay. There is nothing wrong. And, you know, we're all accepting of this. And she's, after that, she said, okay, our whole household has changed. It's such a better place. So please, please, please communicate with your kids. If they have any sort of experience, or even they come and tell you, like Sarah said, you know, they're seeing jewels on the water. Encourage it. Yeah, they do look like jewels. How beautiful. What colors do you see? Engage with it.
I love that. Yes. And I think in general, actually not even just around magic, just in general, one of the things that I notice is this idea that we forget sometimes as adults that we need to validate the experience of our children, whether it's how they perceive a piece of music or whether it's what they're seeing in nature or, right? Like it, whatever it is, it's validating that they are experiencing their own experience, right? We're all souls in our individual vessels having individual experiences as a community, and that our individual experiences are just as important as the community experience. And I think just generally, even, I mean, even as adults, right? We invalidate each other all the time because we make judgments about things.
That's beautiful.
Yeah.
I love that. That is really profound. I love that. It is, we are all here in these physical bodies. We're magical beings, basically, in these physical, multidimensional
beings. I love that idea. Yes.
In these physical bodies, experiencing a human life. Mm-hmm. And it is truly experience. Everything is an experience, and from different perspectives, different lenses, different angles, we get to have different experience. And that's what a lot of times with my clients, I said, universe is always giving you do-overs. And you may think, well, you know, oh, this is happening the same way. Or sometimes even on the healing journey, I know a lot of clients come and say, you know, I thought I was doing well, but now all of a sudden the same thing is coming to me. Like the same thing doesn't mean you went backward. The same thing is that the universe is giving you an option again and saying to you, hey, what do you want to do over again? You have choice. Do you want to choose the same experience you had before, or you want to do it differently? And I know you've heard me say this before, like buffet.
Yes.
Universe is giving you a buffet, guys. Life is like a buffet that you're getting in there, and you know, you've always had, let's say, Chinese food, or you've always had pizza. And you walk into the buffet now, it's like, okay, you have all these choices. What do you want to experience today? Do you want to try some French cuisine? Or do you want to try some, you know, Thai food? What do you want to try? And that is exactly what universe is offering you, especially in those times that what is in the, again, the reality of the world is showing you it's the same thing. It's really not, because it's an opportunity for a do-over, for you to choose differently and see, well, how can I experience this in this manner? What am I getting this way? What, it's like you looking at it in through different angles, different perspectives each time, and seeing what fits with me. Because again, you're changing all the time as well. So the you today is going to experience something different than the you tomorrow. Same situation, different experience.
Well, and I mean, personally, I just had a very profound experience with this idea of going through something similar and then being able to react to it differently, which is the death of my mother-in-law 3 years ago versus the death of my own mom 3 months ago, 2 months ago. Oh my God, I don't even know. August. So whatever that is, I don't even know time. And just that, because my perspective was so vastly different, my experience with the whole process was actually, I almost said more magical, and I realized that's not true, because the first one was absolutely magical. It was just filled with fear as well. Mm-hmm. So it was magic plus fear. And that the second time it was magic only plus love.
Nice. So
magic plus love versus magic plus fear. Yes. And I think it's that fear aspect that people, like, especially when they have aversion to, like, kind of some of the occulty things out there. I mean, we have Halloween coming up on us, right? So I was just showing somebody, they kind of asked me to come help them with something. And I brought my tarot cards. I have like an oracle deck, which personally I find can be a very helpful tool. However, she kind of immediately recoiled, right? And was like, oh, tarot, like, that's not okay. And I was like, oh, okay. And I actually had just forgotten that some people feel that way. And interestingly, then it was, oh, well, should I be feeling differently? And I was like, no, you should feel the way you feel. But if you want me to introduce you to it in a different way at some point, I can show you this deck, its perspective, how it doesn't have the fear. It's based in love. Because a lot of the ancient arts, right, they kind of get imbued with fear just because they had a different perspective than we do now.
It is, and I think partly it goes back to that fear. A lot of times I tell some of my clients when they first come and they've been reading too much and they've been looking at too many things and just grabbing all the information out there, I tell them, please stop. Just for a month, just for several weeks, or at least, like, give me as much time as you can, just stop. Because a lot of times, and this is not to blame anybody, but again, we're all human, and depending on where we are, we're doing things different. A lot of times, the messages, the intention is good, but because whoever is writing it, they experience life through that lens of what you were talking about, magic plus fear, let's say.
Yes.
That fear aspects comes through, that fear energy comes through in those cards, in that book, in whatever show, program, whatever it is that you're watching, listening to, reading. It comes through and you pick up on that fear energy. So it's not very clean. When you're more grounded in you and you know you and you know your own magic and your own way of doing things, and you sort of like have released all the fear, most of the fears anyway, then when you look at those things, you can sort of distinguish between, yeah, this is a lot of their stuff, the person that wrote it. Well, the message in here, the clean part of this is this, which is for me. Yes. And you leave the fear behind.
Yes.
So I think in those situations that you're talking about, it's in the past, there has been so much fear around it. And even some of the practitioners, to be honest, didn't use it for the intention of love that it was made for.
Yes.
And that has caused, again, where we are today, where a lot of people have the fear of
different kinds
calls.
Of magic.
Exactly.
Yeah. Or tools, even. Like
tools,
sometimes I
yeah.
feel like, yeah, it's magic tools. Certain tools have worse reputations than others. See that right there, that whole idea of perspective, right? I think it also goes to show that when you are working with other people, don't forget, like, don't, like if you go to somebody for a reading of any kind, whether it's tarot or energy or Reiki or acupuncture, right, you want to know what their perspective is before you kind of engage with that. Actually, my voice teacher, I'm hearing her in my head right now saying, you know, you listen to everything somebody tells you about your performance, and then you decide what you're going to take to heart. And I feel like if we could look at the internet that way and look at, you know, books and information around magic that way, it would be so much better, because it is about you deciding what makes sense based on your experience of the world, what you know, and deciding what messages you're going to take on board from that, I think.
Yeah.
So what feels good.
What feels good, exactly. I know there are people that they like crystals. You know, there are people absolutely love crystals. There are people that doesn't do anything for them. And it's fine. It's whatever you can connect with and communicate with. Like I said earlier, there are people that they go in nature and, you know, they connect with it with ease and they receive the messages with ease. And there are people that don't. They just, you know, I remember one time I was walking and there was this hawk like right above us. It wasn't even like that far ahead or behind the tree or anything. It was like right there. It's right there. And there was this father and son, and I told the kid, I said, did you see the hog? And the kid looked up first and see it, and he's like, yeah. And the dad could not see it. And I was like, it's right there. I was like, I don't know where to tell you. It's like right above our head. Just look up and you see it. And you couldn't see it. So, but it's whatever you connect with, and, you know, just trust and let the fears go and know that you're, you know, enjoy, have fun. That's the other part of magic.
Yes.
You got to have fun. You got to laugh about it and have fun. If you can't have fun, it won't be magical.
That is exactly. Actually, what's so funny, you made me think about something else that I wanted to bring up, which was the other thing to remember is that like whatever your background is, whether it's, you know, Hindu, Catholic, or atheist, whatever your background is, one of the things I've been most excited about is that since I don't have a tradition, I don't have ancestral roots I'm aware of, I'm adopted, I actually realized in a weird way, it gives me more freedom of choice. Now, perceived freedom of choice. We all have freedom of choice. However, I realized what I thought was like this burden of not having roots to go to is actually a gift of not being fettered with ancestral tradition that I somehow feel like I am obligated to use. Mm-hmm. And that if there are things in other cultures that speak to you, like for me, for whatever reason, it's Hinduism, lots of signs and messages, hearing voices, speaking Sanskrit, like all kinds of things that are related around Hinduism for whatever reason. So it's no, as I said to my father, I'm not going to become Hindu, but I certainly enjoy certain aspects of it. And so I have certain musical instruments or certain things I'm trying to learn just because I love it and it makes me happy. And that I don't have to feel like somehow that's weird because that's not my culture. And I think that's kind of what I just want to say is even if it's not your culture, right? If it's something that speaks to you, it speaks to you. So be willing to explore it and have fun with it and take it on board. And there's nothing wrong with that. And it's actually not weird because I feel like most magical people that I feel like are fairly fully expressed in themselves tend to have things that are kind of all over the board, really, right? They're not necessarily just, I only follow this one very specific path. It's like they accept everything that speaks to them that comes into their circle and into their heart, and they take it on board. So
it's because we follow our highest joy.
Yes. Ooh, highest joy. Yes.
We are not bound by I can't, I won't, I should, all those things. It's whatever speaks to your heart, really. You follow it because it brings you joy. It's fun. It's nice. Sarah knows this. She's my music teacher, y'all. I just got a didgeridoo and I'm trying it out. I have no idea why. It just spoke to me. I'm like, okay, this is going to be fun. The guitar has been there for many years, but you know, at 50, I said, why not? I'm just going to learn the guitar.
That's right.
But it's whatever speaks to you, brings you joy. It's not, and I think part of that, when you're trying those new things, it's some of it is fear of what others are going to think. Some of it is fear because there's always this aspect for a lot of people. Somehow we just want to perfect things. We want to be really good at it instead of, I just want to have fun. I don't even freaking care if I'm good or not. I could be the worst guitar player. If I'm enjoying it, I'm enjoying it. Who cares? And that goes back to the original thing I said with the magic. You're doing it for your own fun, for your own joy. Let the voices go.
Yes.
Everything you do. And I loved what you said earlier, too, about what your voice teacher said. That's sort of what I've always said for art. And when I've told kids about art, is it doesn't matter. Like, they would come and say, what do you think about this? I'm like, it doesn't matter what I think. Do you love this? Does it make you happy? They're like, yeah. I said, then it's beautiful. That's it. Right there. If you love it and you're happy with it, that's all that matters. It does. You shouldn't care what I think or anybody else thinks in this class.
That's right. Yeah.
So, yeah, I think one of the stories for my artwork, I had an art exhibition and this older gentleman came up and said, you know, your art reminds me of those psychiatry images that the ink blots. They remind me of those. And I looked at him and I smiled. I said, okay, if it reminds you of that, I hope it's a good experience for you. If it's not, you're welcome to leave and not be bothered by the artwork.
That's so funny.
So you should have fun. Anything you do, anything you touch, especially with the magic realm, have fun, highest joy. That's what it can't trust.
Yeah, I love that. Yes, the highest joy for sure. Wow, I don't know where to go from there. That was good.
That's it. If you have final, we're almost at our 30 minutes. So if you have something more to add for people to close us off, let's go.
I mean, I think the main thing is understanding I knew there was one other thing, was this idea of what we're talking about, this highest joy. It sounds simple. And once you understand how to access it, it is simple. It might not always be the easiest thing to figure out for yourself in the beginning, what that means, what that is. That's fine. Even just looking for it is fun. And that I cannot explain how life-changing it is either. Like, seriously, this profundity of what we are talking about right now cannot be overstated. And that the experience of your daily life shifts and changes when you're able to have all of these little moments strung together of joy. And it feels pretty amazing. Am I always able to maintain that? Nah, there's times where I'm not that excited about anything at the moment. And that's fine too, right? That's just part of our experience as humans. So anyway, just understand that, yes, go ahead.
No, I was going to say, you're saying something important and I want to bring it out for everybody to hear it again.
Okay.
It's very important what she's saying, because everybody thinks life, they look at life in days, in weeks, in that length, where it really is moments. When you look at your day in those moments that were really blessed, were really happy, were really good, and you really enjoyed it, that's all that's going to matter. It's not that you're not going to have those other things as well, but when you're sort of focused more on today was a good day because of this moment, rather than, oh, you know, I had this bad moment and this bad moment. Start looking at the moments in your day, not the days in your moments, if that makes sense.
No, I love that. That is awesome. Yes, absolutely. And it feels so much better to live this way. Let me just say, as someone who lived not this way for most of my life, this last 6 months in particular has just been awesome. Awesome.
You heard it, people. Awesome. We're going to leave it at awesome. So everybody have an awesome day.
Yes.
Awesome, magical day.
Yes.
Week, month, moments, lots of awesome, magical moments for all you guys. And as always, thank you guys for joining us. If you like the YouTube channel, subscribe. If you're listening on a podcast, again, subscribe, like, share. And happy to have you guys here with us. Thank you. Love you guys. Bye.
Love you. Bye.